the reason why we were so afraid is quite apparent. As we witness the destruction we have made,
my talk for today is Come Out of the Shadows, Holy Child of God. Today's reading, which Reverend Vincent did so beautifully, the very first line says, there is a hush in heaven, a happy expectancy, a little pause of gladness in acknowledgement of the journey's end. It's really a beautiful line. It's what has already happened, and in time is happening. That hush is taking place right now. We have 22 spirits here. We seem to be separate. We're really one. In love. Performing the miracle right now. We showed up. We showed up in oneness. And heaven has great expectancy for us now. Heaven reaches out to us. This beautiful light of love is reaching out for us. And like today's lesson said, we're healing. We chose to come here today to come out of the shadows of isolation, of guilt, of pain and suffering. And so heaven knows that we have, wherever we are on the journey, has great anticipation for us. We have to accept that. We have to accept and claim we are healed and we are healing. And we can do that when we do what this reading is suggesting to us. Those clouds of guilt, of shame, are just really clouds, right? They're just mist. Here in San Francisco, we have a foggy season. Sometimes it feels like the foggy season is all the time. But in truth, at times it's foggier than others, especially in the summer. For some reason, whatever the weather is, the fog is here. But what we know about that is eventually it burns off. Throughout the day, the light shines upon the mist, and gradually it dissipates. Is it any different for us that when we're willing to come out of the shadows of our guilt and expose that to light, that we expect and we experience heaven. We experience the release. We all know, as Course in Miracles students, that the ego manifests itself in many, many different ways. These clouds of guilt, these shadows. We know it can be special relationships. We know it can be false idols. But we also know that there are certain times when we are reading the Course, we're maybe talking or sharing with a fellow student, maybe we're in a meditation, or we're just talking with somebody that doesn't even have, maybe not even, might not even be a Course in Miracles student. It doesn't matter. They are holy child of God. And we know that Spirit speaks to us all the time. And sometimes we get that experience of the ancient memory, that time before we all forgot the laugh, the time before when that thought arose within our minds that we could be separate, that we could replace our source, love, that we could be our own little mini demigods, if you will, of individuality. We all remember that, that there was a time before. Now, maybe it happened to you when you were a child. Maybe it happens to you often now, when amidst the going-ons of the world. Course in Miracles says this: what but Christ's vision would I use today when it can offer me a day in which I see a world so like to heaven that an ancient memory returns to me? Think about what that says now. It's saying to claim the miracle now. Wherever you are in that process, maybe you're experiencing some distress. Maybe you're pursuing an idol. But don't we all know, right? Even in pursuing the idol, it's a child's game, isn't it? The special relationship, the love. For me, recently, it's been the shiny penny. Reverend Tony, I saw you laugh there. Yes, it's a shiny penny. I have taken an interest in learning about finances and the stock market and cryptocurrency. And it's really kind of, actually, it's kind of fascinating. Now I'm learning a bit more, though, about also big tech and how it's taken over the internet. It's fascinating. But, you know, at times I get caught up in like, oh, my gosh, this is a great way. I could make lots of money if I do this trade or do this bet or do this and that, you know. And sometimes I'm in that pursuit. But then the ancient voice, the ancient memory calls me back. And, you know, it's fine. What I know as a course student, it's fine. Whatever I want to do, it's great because I'm learning something different. I'm learning something new. Maybe my personal wealth is increasing some, but it has nothing to do with my peace. It has nothing to do with my, you know, with my value. It's not who I am. You know, I'm you. I'm every one of you, and you're me. We're all holy children of God. And we play in these different games that we choose to play, and that's fine, but it's not necessarily who we are. And so we may pursue these different things, but it's not really, really what we are. In The Wizard of Oz, there's a famous scene where Glinda, the good witch, comes down to the Munchkins, who are afraid because all of a sudden this stranger named Dorothy has come into their city of Oz. And, you know, Glinda descends from the heavens and, you know, of course, in the story, she's the good witch. She's not the wicked witch of the East. She's the good witch. She descends down. And at one point she says to the Munchkins, who are the people that inhabited Oz, come out wherever you are. And of course, the Munchkins, inspired by the good witch, start coming out and start seeing, who is this strange person? Well, sometimes we're all the Munchkins, aren't we? Sometimes we get in a place where we can be terrified. We can be afraid of different things. Our good witch is Jesus or the Holy Spirit. And what does Jesus say to us? Come out, come out. Come on, holy child of God, come out of those shadows. You don't need that special relationship. That's a holy child of God. You just need to love them up. They're just innocent. Love them up. Forgive them. right? Don't hide in the shadows of guilt. Don't hide in attack. Don't hide in avoidance. Come out. Love them. See them as yourself. Come out wherever you are. Now, as we all know, these are wonderful teachings and wonderful metaphors, but they're oftentimes things we need to remember and practice. And recently, you know, I've been having these more and more experiences of kind of coming out of the shadows and into the light. A Course in Miracles tells us that sometimes, you know, coming out into the light or coming out to love can be scary. In my class in our class, the Thursday evening LGBTQ class and beyond class, we were talking about that the thing we fear the most, we think it's all these other things, you know, making our transition, terrible illness, financial bankruptcy, the breaking up of a relationship, losing friends or family. We think that's what we fear, but that's the ego's parlor game. What we really fear is being in the presence of God's love. That's our biggest fear, loving in the moment. I was sharing also with that same class recently for 3 or 4 weeks in my job. I've had some really challenging times. The people I work with, have what the world calls mental health, you know, challenges. And I experienced attack and verbal attacks. And I experienced really bizarre behaviors. And, I began to realize that I was responding really well from spirit, from love and forgiveness. And at the same time, I was terrified. I was terrified, you know, like I had that feeling like I would some of my friends after coming, kind of stepping off the floor where we work with the students, you know, and my hands would be cold as ice. And yet I knew, not always, but in many times, I was providing whatever feedback or intervention was needed at that time. And I thought to myself, wow, you know, what happened? What's different, you know, that's happening? And that's what I kind of related to. Like, we are all kind of peeling the onion, right? We're all peeling the onion. You know, the onion, the layers are clouds of guilt, right? Anxiety, whatever it might be. And so I got it, that sometimes doing the miracle, right, just being inspired, comes with some terror. Sometimes the terror precedes it. And that's when the miracle reveals itself at the end. You know, there's a popular expression I don't think it's Course in Miracles, but, you know, in kind of the vernacular of our times, this too shall pass. And that's hard. That's hard. Today's reading was taken from The Last Obstacle to Peace. It's the fear of God, right? The fear of God. And of course, the Course uses language that we can understand. And what it really means, it's the fear of our oneness. Oh my God, I really am that person who maybe in my past abused me, or maybe I abused them. You know, I really am the person or the institution that committed great crimes upon humanity. Oh my gosh, I played that role. Maybe I was the victim. Maybe I was the perpetrator. Somewhere along the line, I've done both, if we're honest, you know, on a larger scale or a smaller scale. So how do we extend peace and love? Well, the Course, as some of my students in class on Thursday say, the Course doesn't compromise. The Course says that we are going to stand before our source love at some point. The judgment is really going to be that none of this happened and we're all innocent. But there's probably going to be a precedent, something preceding it, that is going to be terrifying. You know, terrifying. You know, and we don't know what it's going to be. Maybe it's when we prepare our part, preparing for our transition. Maybe it's going to be with a relationship that was so important to us in our lives. But this is what we know. We know to keep working the miracle. Keep working the miracle, no matter what. When we stand in guilt, when we stand in terror, when we stand in our resistance, our stubbornness, no, I don't want to do that. That's okay. Keep working the miracle. Keep praying. Keep loving. Keep forgiving. Keep remembering who the Holy Child of God is. It's all of us. It's all of us in every situation. Whether we're driving in the car and someone's driving us crazy as we're driving amongst the streets of San Francisco, which happens to me, probably one of my biggest forgiveness lessons is just driving to work in the morning. Or, you know, it's our relationships. You know, it's the people we love and the people we hate. And we work the miracle all the time. Because we know our function, like today's lesson says, is salvation. That's our function. It's the undoing. It was provided for us at the beginning. And all we do is we embrace that. Over the past couple of weeks, I remember Reverend Tony's been talking to us. Why do we go to classes? Why do we maybe go to more than one class? Because we forget, right? Boy, the ego certainly will serve us up a delicious, delectable grievance, you know? Hey, talk about coming out of the shadows. Come out of the ego shadows. What is the ego? Oh, remember this. Remember this hurt. Remember this wound. Remember the grievance that you have against that political party. This grievance you have against this religious institution. My experience. You know, remember this grievance you have about authority. Really? Well, I mean, we're all mature here. We, guess what, folks? We all have an authority problem, right? We all have an authority problem. Now, that doesn't mean sometimes we don't have to speak truth to power, because we do. We do have to speak truth to power. And when guided by spirit and in the light, and we speak truth to power sometimes, and I think that frees, you know, has freed the human spirit more and more, you know, in our experience. But the most important part is to not forget to see the holy innocence in the other. And to come to those who need healing. I may be terrified sometimes in my personal relations, in my work. I'll be honest, I'm a person, I don't like conflict. You know, I don't like conflict. But what I have noticed recently is that more and more, I'm willing to speak up. And that's because my mind is healing. And I'm willing just to say, in a very, I feel, non-confrontational way, I just say my piece. And they can say their piece. And you know what? If they can say their piece, and I can say my peace, we can both be at peace. It doesn't have to cause us to be separate. There's a reason why we have these different experiences, perceptions, right? Conservative, liberal, vaccine, no vaccine, right? They're served up to us for healing opportunities. Not to further divide us, even if we have different positions, but to be healed, to be able to have the opportunity to bring A Course in Miracles to even a pandemic, right? To even a situation in the world where apparently the whole world shuts down. But the miracles didn't shut down. We didn't shut down. We went to work. We worked the miracles. We worked the miracles because all of us are holy children of God, whether you're a miracle student or not. We didn't forget to work the miracles. We came out of the shadows. We came out of the clouds of guilt. We shined that mist away with the light of love. And because of that, we continue to inspire and to heal. And soon, that hush of heaven and journey's end will be for all of us. And we'll all experience it as one, as we were meant to be. And that's my talk for today. Thanks, everyone.
So afraid is quite apparent as we witness the destruction we have made. We not to heaven.